Hey, what's up guys? In this video, I will show you how to get all main characters and their influence throughout the game. I will also show you all ways to make them leave you or lose them. I will show only a tiny part of the dialogue in this video, but before you watch this, beware of major spoilers. If you want to see the full dialogue and all different choices, I've made a bunch of separate videos for that. You can check the links in the description for all videos I will use in this one. Ake of the Null will be the first one you encounter. You will find him on your way through the first map Lyria. He's preparing himself for a fight with the Manticore.
Identify yourself, sir, and your intent.
Ake of the Null, I am dubbed, and my design I never conceal.
You can then choose to help him defeat the Manticore in exchange that he will join you after.
We shall help you find and fight the Manticore. Provided you then pledge to help us fight an even fiercer and filthier beast.
He does not agree immediately, so you have to insist it.
A manticore. How great is its appetite?
And he will finally give in to it. Now to fulfill your oath, you have to slay the manticore.
The beast is near.
And I beheld the beast! Profane horns didst adorn his wicked brow!
After the fight, he will decide if he will join you.
Will you swear to serve me? Are you prepared to take an oath?
I am not, Your Grace. I can serve only the gods. Yet, I do believe them to be on your side as one unjustly and treacherously attacked. Thus I see nothing wrong in assisting you.
Then I am content and welcome you in my ranks, Sir Ake of the Null.
He will not join you when you kept the stolen priestess's treasure from the bandits in an earlier side quest.
Neve answered after a moment's consideration.
I am not, Your Grace. I can serve only the gods. Yet you seem to hold them in low regard. I noted monastic silver in your wagons.
A war is on. I must have the means to pay all new recruits.
My lady, my pockets needn't concern you. I do not fight beside blasphemers.
Ake spurred his mount and disappeared in haste. I know not what Meave thought. Perhaps she felt some pangs of conscience.
Now there are many ways to lose him again. First of all, you can just miss him if you wish him good luck and you will never see him again.
For my folk, I greatly appreciate Sir Ake of the Null. Godspeed.
And to you, Your Majesty.
If you decide to skip the Manticore fight, he will get angry at you and leave once you enter the second map, Aedirn.
What's the problem?
What's the problem? Your solemn oath you have broken. Through lies, you tricked me into evil, into forsaking my mission.
The Manticore, you mean? You must understand we had weightier matters at hand and...
Enough! I shall neither heed nor follow one bereft of honor. Farewell, and may the gods summon mercy for you.
In the second map Aedirn, you will come across a group of Nilfgaardians under attack by ghouls. If you decide not to help them, Ake will single-handedly charge at the ghouls.
When Ake stepped into her path,
"'Tis ignoble!"
the knight cried.
"No matter the crest they bear, men they are still, and I, Ake of the Null, shall race to their succor, even if I must pitch battle alone."
Without awaiting the queen's response, Ake lowered his lance, spurred his mount, and charged at the beasts.
If you then again choose not to help them, you will lose him, and he will probably die.
Meave said,
"'Tis good he has left our ranks. We return to the others."
As for Ake, he was never heard from again.
In the third map Mahakam, there are also a few ways to lose him, starting with the dragon fight.
Queen, we gotta make haste to the rescue!
Smother your fears, Sir Dwarf,
Ake proclaimed. Without waiting for Mee's reply, he dropped his lance and galloped headlong towards the burning city.
Follow me! Slay the viper!
If you choose not to help the dwarves and attack the dragon, Ake will leave you.
And Ake of the Null, the famed monster slayer, he could not believe his own eyes. Watch helplessly as a dragon reduces house after house to ash, murders an entire town. Oh no, A knight errant could never do such a thing.
If you do decide to help the dwarves, the dragon will flee to her cave, where you can decide to kill it or spare her life. If you choose to spare her life, Ake will leave you.
My subjects, I would...
Your Grace, 'tis not right.
Calm down, Sir Ake. What's the problem?
The deed you've committed, most foul. As the good book says, whosoever standeth idle in the face of evil proveth guilty of the same. Know that I never stand idle, yet I cannot stop you from doing so. Thus I must leave. I refuse to play any part in the wickedness you perpetrate.
Sir Ake.
Farewell, Queen, and may the gods have pity on your soul.
Later in Mahakam, you will come across a dwarf asking for help finding his family heirloom. If you choose to help him, you will find out he was not looking for a heirloom, but a lost treasure. If you decide to keep the treasure for yourself, Ake will leave you.
Your Grace, 'tis not right.
Calm down, Sir Ake.
In the end of Mahakam, you come across two dwarven clans fighting about who has the biggest mountain peak. Eventually, they ask you to measure the height of the two peaks. If you choose to lie about the biggest peak, Ake will leave you.
Perhaps you could recalibrate the results a wee bit?
'Tis most lowly and ignoble,
Ake cried out in protest.
A knight, his honor would never stain with such a lie.
Alas, no matter the result I give, half the dwarves will be displeased.
Your Grace, 'tis not right.
And that covers all ways to lose Ake. But there's one more quest which Ake has influence on. In Angren, the 4th map, you will come across a small fort in the middle of the swamp. Gerwin, the leader, will invite you inside if you swear an oath to respect our customs.
At which to warm your limbs, on condition you pledge to me one very small thing, to respect the sacred laws of hospitality.
So be it. I do solemnly swear before the gods and my ancestors.
Once aside, you will learn Gerwin has an evil way of ruling, and you will get a choice to attack him or respect the oath you made. If you choose to respect the oath and leave without a fight, Ake will attack him nonetheless, and your army will follow, which makes you break your oath.
No, Your Grace!
Ake of Danelle shouted.
This is not right! I'll not leave these peasants to these brutes!
Ake drew his sword and with one mighty strike ran two of Gerwin's soldiers through. The others needed no orders, and fearing for their lives, promptly leapt at their Lyrian guests.
I didn't think a queen would so easily break her word!
Neve's force left the fort before dawn. She rode at the fall, lips pursed, jaw clenched. A stain on her honor. She'd broken her word. Apart from all else, it stung on the inside.
And now for the second character, Black Rayla. You will encounter Rayla when you first enter the second map, Adern. Some Scoia'tael are preparing to hang her just before Meath comes to the rescue.
Well said. Lyrians, attack!
A thousand thanks, Your Grace. Heard many tales of your valor. Pleased to see there weren't just flattery and propaganda.
Black Rayla. Hagar, we saw you there. You command King Demavend's special forces.
She will join your army, traveling with you towards King Demavend, and will have a big contribution throughout the map. At the end of Adern, King Demavend suggests you to go to Mahakam, and he will send Rayla with you as your guide.
Rayla!
Yes, Your Grace?
You've been to Mahakam with me many times.
Once in Mahakam, Rayla will decide if she will stay with you or leave you. To my knowledge, there are three choices on which is decided if Rayla stays with you. If you choose two or three of those in favor of Rayla, she will stay. And if you choose two or three against her, she will leave. The first choice is about the human massacre quest, where non-humans slaughtered all humans in their town. If you choose to escort them to the nearest town, it will have a negative effect on Rayla. If you choose to let Rayla punish them, it will have a positive effect on her. The second choice is about the Skyatel Field Hospital. If you let Rayla kill the wounded elves, it will have a positive effect on her. If you refuse to let Rayla kill them, it will have a negative effect on her. The third choice is about the burial of Eldaine after the fight with him. If you grant Eldaine a burial, it will have a negative effect on Rayla. If you refuse to give him a burial, it will have a positive effect on Rayla. If Rayla is positive about you, you can choose to let her stay with you.
No aid can I dismiss, and yours in particular.
I'm humbled, Your Grace.
But you can also choose to send her away and lose her.
You must return. Forgive me.
If Rayla is negative about you, she doesn't want to stay with you, and she will go home.
I received orders. I fulfill them to their end.
And what will you do now?
Our paths diverge, not more. I return home now, where new orders surely await.
From now on, there will be only one way to lose her. In Mahakam, you can choose to help find some lost, young dwarven drag diggers.
Your Majesty, we need to find our youth.
You will find out the dwarves joined the Skyatel, and they will attack you. After the fight, when Meave decides to bring the young dwarves back to their parents, Rayla will kill all the dwarves against Meave's will.
Without entering into a discussion, she ordered the prisoners taken to be tried and judged by their kin and elders.
Along her way, Meave heard cries. She rushed to see what the ruckus was about. Upon seeing Black Rayla spattered with blood, she expected the worst. Rayla had nothing to say in her defense. In point of fact, she exuded pride.
Mahakam had been free of Skoyatel, till now. We'd have done all a questionable favor by bringing back a wagon full of enraged youth wearing squirrel tails. They'd have posed as martyrs for a just cause. They'd have shown off their scars and persuaded the clans to make war on humans.
You will get to choose if you will let Rayla stay after the scandal or leave your army. If you choose to send her away, you will lose Rayla.
That separates a soldier, a warrior, from one who commits murder,
said Meave.
That line you crossed today. You are to leave my ranks immediately, and never do I wish to see you again.
Rayla said nothing. She merely bowed in an excessively courtly manner, then moved off down the slope. Yet even once she disappeared, a clear red trail remained in the snow where she had passed. A trail of dwarven blood that had dripped from her armor.
If you decide to let her stay, Isbel will leave you. But this will be seen in Isbel's part, starting right now. You will come across Isbel in a side quest in the second map Adurn. She has been captured by bandits. After you freed Isbel, you will learn she's a sorcerer. But she had pledged to herself never to hurt a human being again, and that's why she didn't escape by herself.
What is your name, sorceress?
Isbel of Tretagor.
I take it you did not keep company with bandits willingly.
Not at all. They kidnapped
Meave tries to recruit Isbel in her army, but she will refuse at first.
It was stolen from me along with my country. I strive to reclaim what was taken, and admit the help of a sorceress would prove useful.
Thank you, my lady. But you must know, an army is no place for me.
Only after seeing the heavily wounded Xavier, she will change her mind.
Yes, Your Grace.
Gods, what happened to him?
But she will only aid you as a healer and will not fight.
I shall go with you, but never shall I use magic to take a life. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, you have put it quite plain, and rather bluntly.
Forgive me, Your Grace. It has been long since I played the host. I forget the custom.
Your spells mean more to me than your manners. Welcome to our ranks, Isbel.
You will also get a choice to refuse her anyway, and you won't get a chance to get Isbel again.
If you wish to grant us a favor, you'd best to go your own way.
I understand. In that case, farewell, Your Grace. May the men who die by your hand not return to haunt your dreams.
The sorceress' words sounded like a warning and a confession. Meave tried later to find out more about Isbel of Tretagor, but no sorceress she ever met had heard of the woman.
In a fourth map, Angren, Isabel will ask you to talk to her.
I must speak to you when you find a free moment. I'm pleased to see you again, Mom. You need something?
You wish to speak with me? In private?
Yes, Mom. I've given thought to certain matters. The time's come to explain and reveal my decisions. I've not been entirely honest.
She will confess she actually comes from Nilfgaard and fought for the Empire. But she has great regret now and wants to help Meev and use her magic to fight.
I wish to fight at your side.
All deserve a second chance. Yet from now on, there are to be no more secrets between us.
Certainly. I thank you. You've no idea what this means to me.
Good. Oh, and Isabel, this must stay between us alone. For your own sake.
I appreciate the concern, Mom. But you needn't worry about me. I've lived for some time in the North. And dare say I know how to get by.
You will lose the healer card and will get a destroyer card instead. If you want to keep the healer card, you must not talk with Isabel. During the conversation, you will get two chances to send Isabel away and lose her.
You must leave. It's time. Forgive me, Isabel, but I can't allow you to stay. If you'd been honest from the start, perhaps, but I fear you must leave.
I understand. Just know I wished, and want still, nothing but the best for you and your folk. Good luck, and God speed you on your way.
There are a few ways to lose Isabel. Let's start with the missing dwarves in the Tur Map Mahakam, the same quest as seen in Rayla's part. When you choose to let Rayla stay after she killed the dwarves, Isabel will leave. The only way to keep both Isabel and Rayla is to skip this quest.
And she is one of the best warriors I have under my command,
said the Queen.
Mom, I've come to tell you I must leave your army.
What? Why?
Against my better judgment, I joined you to heal your wounded. I realize now that was a mistake.
What exactly do you mean?
What you did runs counter to all my beliefs. You had your reasons, and have them still, I know. Yet I've no desire to abet them. I'd feel shame to lend a hand.
What can I do? Is there anything that would make you stay?
No, Mom. Farewell.
So be it. Good luck and Godspeed, Isabel.
In the fourth map, Angren, you will, at one point, get a dialogue about some deserters in your army. You will have to choose to punish them, but not kill them, or use the official punishment and hang them. If you choose to hang them, Isabel will leave you.
Me as criminals I must judge. You well know how I deal with wrongdoers in wartime, without delay nor mercy. Sergeant, every third man to the scaffold, the others to be lashed. That's an order.
Mom, I've come to tell you I must leave your army.
What?
In the fifth map, Rivia, you will come across an old settlement where Meev used to go when she was younger. She's excited to visit it again, but she will find out all old residents she knew have been replaced by Nilfgaardian settlers. If you choose to send the Nilfgaardian settlers away, Isabel will leave you.
I shall tell them myself.
Meev stood on a bench, drew, then brandished her sword and yelled at the top of her lungs.
Out! Go! Begone! This is our land, our country!
Mom, I've come to tell you I must leave your army.
What?
A little bit further in Rivia, you will come across a town which is heavy defended by Nilfgaardians and good quality weapons. After the fight, you will learn a local blacksmith made the weapons for the Nilfgaardians.
A man knelt in shackle.
Who's this?
Our blacksmith, Tordor!
If you choose to kill the blacksmith, Isabel will leave you.
Gave the invader arms. The invader then used them to spill the blood of your neighbors, countrymen.
Began Meev, her jaw clenched.
Blood for blood. We'll now spill yours. Take this traitor to the square, and off with his head!
Mom. And that covers all ways to lose Isabel. but there are three more quests where Isbel has a big influence on. In Mahakam, there is a quest about a dwarven foreman who got accused of the death of many dwarven miners and is at a point to be stoned to death. When you choose to defend the foreman, the dwarves won't stop throwing stones at all and even hit Meave. A fight is about to start until Isbel interferes.
Shino Kren!
Isbel cried out. Her hands began to radiate a fierce light that blinded both dwarves and Lyrians alike.
Have you lost your minds, all of you together? Not had your fill of misfortune yet? Lower your arms at once!
Whether the power of Isbel's magic or the force of her appeal had the greater effect is difficult to say for certain. Either way, both sides suddenly lost the desire to fight. Meave breathed a sigh of relief, aware that if not for Isbel's intervention, a great amount of blood would have been spilled at that cemetery.
Without Isbel, a fight would indeed happen, and you have to kill all the dwarves. In Angren, you have to deal with a sick soldier infected with typhus fever. The medics can't heal him, but Isbel knows a spell to save him if she has the right ingredients.
But where medicine fails, magic may at times stand in. Without giving it two thoughts, Meave called for Isbel.
It's typhus, I've no doubt.
The healer confirmed.
I know a spell that could be helpful. Weigel's cleansing, we call it. It takes time to prepare and many ingredients. Rather costly, all.
Coin's no object,
said Meave.
Get to work at once.
Isbel returned from the local herbalist with herbs valuable and rare. Fern blossoms, mandrake root, comfrey seeds, and more. She then pulled from her bundle a variety of vessels, funnels, retorts, alembics, carafes. Colored concoctions she then brewed, steam and strange odors rising from them. Hours later, after much effort, she had a few drops of a thick substance in a flask. Isbel whispered an incantation, then gave the remedy to the dying man. His tremors and fever subsided at once, the other symptoms fading within hours. At last, Meave could breathe a deep sigh of relief.
Without Isbel, the soldier will die. And even worse, if you take the soldier with you, many more will die of the fever. Another quest in Angren, about the animal sacrifices for the marsh gods. You will get a choice to stop the ritual and destroy the place. When you do this, an old woman will curse you and your army.
I curse you! All of you! In Gernakura's name!
A bit later, your soldiers will throw up blood. They are apparently poisoned by a local herbalist. Isbel will be in time to save them all.
Happily, Isbel concocted an antidote in time to deliver the soldiers from a certain and agonizing death. The mage explained their misfortune had not issued from a dark, corrupt force, but from simple human wickedness. Her calming voice and gentle smile lifted the soldiers' spirits. Trusting in her care, they soon wholly forgot the so-called curse.
Without Isbel, the poisoned soldiers will die, and the others will think a curse killed him. And that was all for Isbel. We will now continue with Gabor. You will meet Gabor when you first enter Mahakam.
Towards Mahakam, the dwarven homeland. There, among snow-capped peaks, someone awaited.
Your Grace, a taste?
No, none. Though your offer of repast I value, good sir.
Oh, no need of that. Gabor, please. Enchanted to make your acquaintance.
He will then accompany you as your guide through all Mahakam. At the end of Mahakam, there will be a big choice for you to make, which depends if Gabor will stay with you or not. In the end, just before you meet Bruverhoek, you will find out the Ziggurin clan, the clan that Gabor belongs to, has murdered another clan.
So you are responsible for the deaths of all those dwarves?
Me? I didn't raise a finger, tried to stop them in fact.
If you want to keep Gabor with you, you should not tell the truth to Bruverhoek.
I did not know.
Course you didn't, humans. First they cock it up, then they ask how it works.
At the moment Meave is ready to leave Mahakam, Gabor will step in front of her. He wants to leave Mahakam together with Meave.
For I resolved to leave Mahakam. For all time.
And where will you go?
Then again, wherever you lead me.
You could choose to take him with you,
Gabor,
or reject him.
I am not.
Oh, thank you, Meave.
If you choose to reject him, you will lose Gabor.
The virtue we have but once, Gabor. You threw yours away, so I've no place for you in my force.
Your Grace, you must understand, I acted on the orders of my...
There is nothing I must, and that was my last word.
Gabor would have wished to say more, but in the end he bit his moustache and walked away without another word. To where? Alas, that I do not know.
If you decide to tell the truth to Bruvahook about the Zekerins, the future of Gabor will not look so bright, and you will lose him.
Never learn the truth, for I learnt it just moments ago. 'Twas the Zekerins who killed the Fuchses.
The Zekerins?
All clans were to be represented at the feast, save one, of course, the Zekerins. For they had already learned their punishment. The entire clan was banished from Mahakam. An exception was made for one of their number, for Gabor, who was beheaded before the day was done.
There's one more way to lose Gabor. In a fifth map, Rivia, you will come across a city called Gradabor, taken by the Nilfgaardians. During the battle, the townsmen will suddenly open the gate for you, making the fight a lot easier for Meave. After the battle, when Meave asks to repay her debts to the townsmen will ask to send away all the non-humans the Nilfgaardians had welcomed in the city. If you fulfill this request, Gabor will leave you.
Your city,
Meave began slowly after a pause.
Your rules.
Gabor Zekerin was not the silent type and was wont to be blunt. He asked to see the Queen at the first opportunity.
We haven't always seen eye to eye,
began the dwarf, a note of pain and sadness in his voice.
But I've always respected your decisions. That is, till the day. I fear this is where we part, lass. I got to go. So fare ye well.
Meave made no attempt to stop him. She knew not to try. Gabor had left her side, never to return.
If you deny the request, Gabor will be very happy with you, and you will get an upgraded Gabor card,
began the Queen.
So listen closely, all. Whether elf, dwarf, gnome, or human, it matters not. My subjects are equal.
Come nightfall, the Lyrians pitched camp. Meave sat down and stared into the fire. Her officers, advisors, kept their distance, unsure if her eyes burned with the fire's reflection or a fury deep inside. Only Gabor dared approach her.
You can. Not lying back, I asked myself, Gabor, you bampot, you gone bar me? Left my home, clan, family. And for why? To follow a human queen. But the day you showed me, I made the right choice.
Gabor stood and went back to the mess tent. Had he lingered a bit longer, he'd have seen Meave smile.
There is one more way to upgrade the Gabor card. In Mahakam, there is a quest about a lost treasure. You will find it in Blackbrook Vale. The treasure will turn out to be loads of holy guldens, a dwarven currency to purchase nourishment and meat, but it is not worth much gold.
What's this bloody crap? Tokens of some sort?
Aye, that's right. Holy guldens, we call them. They're, currency in Mahakam. Get our wages in them. Use them to cop victuals and hooch.
Gabor will suggest to fund a feast and invite the local dwarves with you.
The tokens we use to purchase nourishment and meat, and what you've got in those chests, why, that'll do to fund a feast the likes of which Mahakam's not seen since Bruver was sworn in as Elder-in-Chief.
If you choose to do so, you will get the upgraded Gabor card.
As Meave's force could not possibly fit in a tavern, the feast was laid out in a storehouse.
And that will be all for Gabor. Let's continue with Barnabas. In Mahakam, you will come across a group dwarves preparing an execution through barrel roll. The one who will be executed is a gnome called Barnabas. You can choose to interrupt the execution for a moment, and you will have a chance to save Barnabas. You can either pay for his freedom or ask about the exact laws, which will conclude Barnabas will be freed.
Which stricture did he violate?
What did... How did... How's it a wench, and a human one to boot, know about the code? Ugh, fine. Now get the hell out of that barrel and out of my sight, you hairy hamshanker.
My lady, I haven't a way to thank you.
That we've yet to discuss. Perhaps first we should learn each other's names?
Of course. What a prat of me. Barnabas. Barnabas Beckenbauer. To friends, Bibi.
When Meef asks him to join our army, Barnabas will accept.
You. I'll do what you ask to pay off my debt.
And thus, for the first time in Lyrian annals, a gnome enlisted with the army. And though Barnabas Beckenbauer was diminutive of body, this new recruit would prove his worth on more than one occasion.
If you do not interfere, the dwarves will carry out the execution and Barnabas will die.
To urge her forward. Soon after, she heard a loud wailing cry, the sound of wood splintering, 100 dwarves cheer, and then quiet.
The same will happen when you won't pay for his freedom or bring up the exact laws. There are two quests where Barnabas has a big influence on. In Mahakim, a group dwarves who are going to settle in Blackbrook Vale will ask to travel with you until they reach their location. Many more dwarves try to settle in Blackbrook Vale, but for some reason they all died. When they reach the location, they will learn the area is affected with monsters. Thinking they found the reason for the deaths of the previous settlers.
Could the beasts they felled have killed the previous lot of colonists? Perhaps the curse that had long hung over Blackbrook Vale was at last broken.
Barnabas will find something else, the real reason.
Prepared to go at the huts to repair them, when one of their number cried out,
"Hold! There's something here! Something reeky!"
A voice most familiar, thought Meave. Yes, for it belonged to Barnabas, the rescued inventor. Finally, Barnabas stood, brushed his backside clean, and announced his findings.
Well, we know with some certainty the reason for the settlers' demise. 'Twere not beasts, no. They prowled in later, drawn by fresh graves. 'Twas the water. Oh, roll your eyes and whirl your fingers all you want, and then peer at the brook. Nary a fish. All poisoned by subterranean fumes.
The dwarves hemmed, hawed, and grumbled, and were a heartbeat from abandoning the Vale for good. Then Barnabas reached into his satchel and extracted a device of his own making he termed an aqua purificator. That is to say, a water cleaner, as odd as it may seem.
You need but siphon water through this straw. Then drink up, worry-free.
Without Barnabas, the settlers will die again and nobody will know why. In the fifth map, Rivia, you will come across a city called Broadhead. The villagers will complain about Mahakim floating Rivia with their metal goods for years now, which the local smiths can't compete with, and resolded the city to go to shit. But then Barnabas will have a suggestion.
Speaking, there's a bit of truth to what the man says.
I'm perfectly aware of that. But what do you want?
I don't mean to toot my own horn, but perhaps I might be of some help?
Do tell how. I'm all ears.
Everything your folk make here, the dwarves of Mahakam make twice as fast and twice as well. You must find a so-called niche, an innovation. And it just so happens innovations
are your speciality.
At the risk of being immodest, exactly. Besides, it might serve the cause of peace to show the folk here, non-humans, are not all bad, that they can help, not just steal human jobs and piss in their milk.
I'll consider it, Barnabas. I shall think and let you know.
If you choose to entrust the city's future to Barnabas, you will lose him. But with his inventions, he will let the city shine again.
Barnabas's proposal. He would manage the city's ailing industry and seek to restore it to health.
Barnabas, just please, do your best not to blow it all up.
Don't you worry, Your Grace. The only boom in this town's future is that of the economic sort.
At first, the Rivian townsfolk were skeptical of the Queen's decision. but Barnabas's schemes bore immediate fruit. Soon the foundries and manufactories were bustling with life. Before long, Meave herself received new goods produced there.
And that will be all for Barnabas. Let's continue with Anjolf. In the fourth map, Angren, you will walk into a Nilfgaardian ambush. During the fight, you will get some unexpected help from Anjolf and the group Skelligan. After the fight, Meave will thank Anjolf, but you will learn they didn't do it to help you, but just for the killing. There are two possible outcomes. Anjolf and his crew will join you, or they will attack you. The outcome will depend on the choice you made about the Skellingen raid with Lippy Goodmund and his crew in the first map Lyria. If you choose to punish and imprison them, Anjolf will attack you.
Not here to help yous, not at all. We're after killing. Nilfgaardians, Lyrians, it's all the same to us. Strife and blood and guts to wash away our shame.
I'm certain we can...
Ready yourself, wench! Stand and fight! Ah! Ah! Skelligar!
Meave proved a skilled warrior and more than a worthy foe. She not only stood and faced Arnulf, she soundly defeated him. Broken, bloodied, the Skelligar lay on the ground.
What are you waiting for? Kill me! Go on, kill!
The queen's blade pierced his breast, and Arnulf seemed to sigh, relieved. His penance done, his wrongs redressed, Arnulf could rest at last.
If you choose to send the raiders in the first map against the Nilfgaardians, Anjolf will join you.
Not here to help yous, not at all. We're after killing.
Join me and you shall have your fill.
Join yousens? Just who the hell are you?
Meave, Queen of Rivia and Lyria.
Meave?
Arnulf said, his tone sobering.
I know the name. Lippy Goodman called ye bold. Praised your courage to the high heaven. So be it. We'll follow ye into fire, wench. Just let us taste of blood. Grant us a death worthy of heroes!
Meave couldn't help but smile, then nodded to accept. The Lyrians stepped aside as tattooed warriors joined their ranks.
Anjolf will not have any influence, so let's continue with Willem. In the fifth map Rivia, you will have a meeting with Willem. Willem will offer to renounce his fealty to Nilfgaard and pledge his forces to Meave. The choice you make here will have a heavy impact on the ending. If you accept Willem's terms, he will join your army. Willem will have big influence on one quest. When you ask House Ober to aid your army with our ballistae, they will refuse it, because they pledged themselves to King Willem. If you have Willem in your army, he will convince them to give their ballistae to Meave.
My liege is King Willem,
Greta calmly retorted. Hearing his name, Willem stepped forward.
I wish to add my name to my mother's entreaty,
said the prince.
We tried to pact with the Empire. We trusted General Epdai's promises, and he broke them, one after the other.
Margravine Greta dropped her gaze. The Oberts had lost lands, their serfs had been deported. Under Nilfgaard's rule, they had lost no less than the other great families.
We can brook no further delay. We must strike, united with all our might. Only thus can we retain hope for a victory.
Without Willem, you will get a choice to attack House Obert, or take your loss and leave them. If you attack them, you will also get the ballistae. If you deny Willem's terms, you won't get him in your army. In the end, when you attack the Rivian castle, he will, however, have a big role in winning the battle. But sadly, the consequence is he will die. But it will prevent Gascon or Reynard from dying. If you decide to capture Willem, he will have a sad ending. He will rot in a cell and die in it. And that will be all for this video. It turned out a lot longer than I expected, but I hope you've enjoyed it. If you did so, please give a like.